Jamey Caldwell, 1 minute out. I want to talk to you about engaging multiple targets, but multiple targets that are at varying distances. You know, this is definitely something that you want to practice on the range when you get the time, because in that everyday carry situation, you know, we're not going to be able to select the closer targets always that we want to hit first and then move to the further targets. We have to assess which is the most likely, or the threat that's going to try to put rounds down on me the quickest, so that I can get to that threat first. So you may have to go from a near or a far target, then to a near target, to another near target, or near to far, whatever it may be. So when you're on the range, make sure that you practice both shooting, you know, the near targets first or your far targets, and back and forth at different levels and different transitions. Now, what is going to help you out with this? What are the little tips that I can relay to you and give to you? Well, some of it comes down to your normal just target transition. So wherever your first threat is, that's where we want our eyes to go. The pistol is going to come up into that first threat, eyes on the threat. All right, let our front sight post or the dot just fall into that line of vision. And then our eyes are going to move to whatever that next threat is, and the pistol is going to come over and follow. Once that front sight post or that dot is right in that line of vision, and we know that line of vision I'm talking about, we're staring at, you know, the tiniest little spot, whether it's a button on the chest or, you know, something in a small area, you know, aim small, miss small. So my eyes are there, the pistol comes over and transitions, because our hands are always going to follow where our eyes go. Eyes go, hands follow. So I make those transitions from one target to the other, eyes first, pistol comes and follows. Once everything's set, I go ahead and squeeze cleanly. All right, I squeeze the trigger so that I don't push and manipulate anything else that the gun is doing. The round's gonna go exactly where your eyes are and where you want it to. Now, what can I do with my body position to help be more effective with that? Number one is we wanna relax our shoulders. You know, too many guys are up and they're shooting very tense. So as I'm up here and I'm looking at a target and I'm locked all the way out and I'm very tense with everything I'm doing, my shoulders are really tight. When I try to make that transition, you can see that there's a big snap and a big wobble where I have to wait for that sight to settle on the target before I squeeze the trigger. But if I relax those shoulders a little bit, when I present the pistol up here, my eyes go, the pistol just moves and snaps over, and it's just right there. It goes exactly where my eyes are, but I'm nice, relaxed, and smooth. You know, that is, again, something that we just have to practice, because in the heat of the moment, in that everyday carry situation, you know, we may not be as relaxed as we want to be. We're going to be, you know, heart's going to be racing, blood pressure's going to be up, you know, we're going to be a little bit more amped up. But the more that you practice this on the range and get comfortable with it, the better you're going to be in those everyday situations. So now we're going to go through and actually shoot some targets and vary from near to far, far to near. You'll see that target transition where I try to stay relaxed through my shoulders. I try to use, you know, that lower portion of my body to actually move that upper portion. So kind of like the turret of a tank, I'm just trying to keep my eyes and everything locked in. All right, you'll notice I'm not moving my head and trying to move my head and get things to follow. I just move my eyes. All right, once I move my eyes, then I just try to bring my body, you know, over and get that sight to line right up with where my eyes are looking. All right, let's go ahead and shoot it, see what it looks like. All right, for this first one, I'm gonna go ahead and go from a near target to a far target, and then a little bit of a wider transition to a mid-range target. All right, here I'm gonna start at a far target, I'll come to a near target, and then transition to a far mid-range target. Right, so you can see there's a little bit of timing difference in there, because obviously our further targets, we want to ensure that we've got a good sight picture on there before we squeeze those rounds off. So our further targets may be a little bit slower when we transition over from one to the other, but the big thing to remember is get those eyes down there exactly where we want to go. Don't stare at the front sight, don't stare at our dot, eyes on the target, get the pistol into our line of vision, eyes shift, right, and the pistol is going to follow.